Hello everybody, XeriaX here, and today we are going to go ahead and play Minecraft. And today I'm going to go ahead and review a mod for you guys. Now this mod here is very excellent. It's a work in progress, which is kind of mind-boggling. But all the less, I still love it, and it's an amazing mod. So let's see, why is there a random furnace there? Hello? Pool of water, do you know? No, you don't. Alright, so anyways, where to start? So basically what this mod does, it adds a ton of cogs. It mechanizes Minecraft. And personally, I thought this is a really cool idea, because if you look at everything, well, come on, it looks pretty damn awesome. Anyways, first off, what you want to do, you want to create a wood cog. Now the recipes are all in these chests, so there's quite a few. Anyways, to make a wooden cogwheel, you've got four sticks and four planks. Put them together and you get this right here. Now, iron cog, it is iron ingots and iron plates. Now, we'll show you how to make plates later, okay? And for brass, it is brass ingots and brass plates. Now, to make brass, it requires zinc ore and copper ore. Now, to make brass, you need 3 copper and 1 zinc. And all the other stuff on here I'll go over later. Alright, so the wood cog here, it can run at 40 revolutions per minute. Iron 70, brass 120. So brass is the best out of all of these, as you guys can probably tell. Anyways, to make them run, you need to make a wood crank. Now a wood crank is 4 sticks just like that. And doing that, you can easily just make them run, which is kinda neat. And also, if you have them all connected up like this, then you'll make all of them run. Now, if you shift-click, or shift-right-click, or crouch-right, yeah, if you crouch-right-click, you can also make it go the other direction. Now, I've set mine for C, that's why I didn't understand it for a second. So, let's just keep that, just in case. Now, rods. It's just 2 sticks side by side, and basically what they do, they, just make... it just sticks them out a little bit, so then you don't have to place them on a solid block. So, as you can see there, you can also run right through them, and I'm trying to get back up here without failing. Not managing that very easily. Alright, now for a pendulum. A pendulum, one of the most amazing frickin' things. Like, okay, hang on. / game mode. One. Alright, so, basically these things right here, they're amazing. Pendulums basically let you automate things, so it's kind of the point of this mod. So let's just quickly go ahead and get ourselves a pendulum here, get us some more brass cogs. There, now we're going to just lay them out here. Now, if we get a pendulum out, it will hook up right here, and it'll start spinning. Now, that will automate everything, which is a really neat concept if you ask me. It looks like it's going a little bit slow. I don't know, maybe if it goes... Yeah, it goes faster if it's like that. There's more on... I guess it goes a little bit slower? Yeah. Something like that. Alright, so let's just go ahead and break that down. And try to move on to the next one. Oh yeah, by the way, they start... Or not. Alright, now the pounder here. The pounder here... oh jeez, I didn't want to do that. The pounder... what you can do, you can go ahead and put certain blocks in here, so you can, here, how to put this. You can go ahead and take stuff like zinc ore, I think zinc ore works, and you can stick it right in here. And what it requires is, that didn't work. It requires mechanical energy, so we're going to go ahead and set up our pendulum once again. I shouldn't have gotten rid of it. So let's just go ahead and set that up, and... get out a pounder. I can find it. Stone pounder. Here we go. Now, this requires mechanical energy, like I said, and you can just put in ore, I believe. No. What can you put in here? I'm trying to remember off by heart. It's not working too well. Cobblestone. You could put cobblestone in it, couldn't you? Yes? No? Maybe? Do you have to hook it up here? Yes, there we go. Okay, you actually have to hook it properly onto there. And... Whoa. What? Oh, it digs below it. What is going on? Oh, I see. You put blocks below it, and then what happens? It smashes into little bits. If you smash cobblestone, you get rocks, and rocks you can throw to deal one heart of damage. So that's actually kind of a cool concept. So that also goes for ore. So, for example, if you put gold ore down here, then it'll transform into gold fragments, which is kind of a cool concept. I personally really like this. It's an amazing mod so far that I have seen. And I think that's a really cool idea to go with everything. All right, so now let's just get rid of that. And yeah, gold ore. I'll just place in one of these, I guess. Yeah, I might as well. I'll just stick it in there, and yeah, maybe, I don't know, something. I don't know, I'll just stick it up here. Get rid of it for a little bit. Now I'll go over the foundry a little bit later. Now, oh no, that's next, I guess. I ran out of it. Oh yeah, that's right. All right, so foundry. Foundry is claystone. Now claystone is I'm trying to remember. Okay, that's it. I'm getting rid of this. It's starting to lag like hell. Now let's see. How did you create claystone? Claystone, 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 claystone. How do I make claystone? Claystone, 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 claystone. Guys, I have bad news. I really can't remember how to make claystone. Oh yeah, you. Ooh, that's right. That's right. That's right. I remember now. I remember. Okay, so basically what you do, you pound a clay block, and then you get compressed clay. Now, once you get compressed clay, you smelt it, I think. You smelt it, and that's how you get the clay blocks. Or, yeah, something like that, and that's how you make the foundry. Anyways, I know that's not really much to help, but, you know, I'm trying, okay? I'm trying. All right, so now what we're going to go ahead and do, we're going to go ahead and teach you how to use the foundry. God, this is going to be a long video. All right, so basically what I've got here, I've got everything that we really need. We need water. Why did we need water again? Ah, hell, I don't remember. So we need that. Get out of here. Iron, zinc, and copper. So we're going to go ahead and put these in. And basically, the cool thing about this is that when you put copper in, you can go ahead and just do that. Now, what you can go ahead and do afterwards, I'm just going to leave that in here. You can actually go ahead and change them if you want them to be ingots or plates. Yeah, see? Or you can even have neither. So that goes with iron and everything. So let's see, now that we've got some copper in here, let's go ahead and put some zinc in. And then we can go ahead and create ourselves some brass. Now, what was it again? It was three copper and one zinc, so we can go ahead and just make. Oh, look at that, it automatically transforms. Yeah. And hey, what's that? I don't know what that is. Oh, that's actual zinc. All right, so guys, that's how you create that, and I believe, let's see, it was iron and zinc, maybe? Yeah, one iron, one zinc, something like that. Hey, buddy. Why you no work? Oh no, I think I remember now. All right, yes, this is a little bit confusing for me as well, but like I said, I'm kind of trying. All right, so let's see. La 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 la. Okay. Nope. Put a banana. No. Maybe it was put some. I can't even remember what this does. So, what did you do to get to galvanize stuff? Like, really, what the hell? Supposed to be one zinc and one iron, so what's going on here? Je ne comprends pas. All right, I'll put in the description what the hell I missed, and I'll teach and just read the description there. And yeah, all right. So now that we've got like a ton of shit and everything, will make an iron rivet. Now, iron rivet is two iron right in the middle and two iron plates right side by side. Now, this is where the fun stuff comes in. This is how to make a steam motor. Now, what you've got to do, you have to make a galvanized iron tube, which is using galvanized iron ingots, and like I said, I'll show you guys how to make them in the description below. Wait, what's this? That's a cylinder. Oh, okay. Alright, first what we've got to do is create a steam generator that can run the steam motor. So the steam generator is a steam container, iron plates, iron rivets, iron bars, and a furnace. To make a steam container, one glass and surround it with galvanized iron ingots. Again, that will be in the description. Now, steam generator, well, it generates steam. You put water in, and you go ahead and make a steam container. Put the steam container in there, and then you give it fuel. So, yeah, just go ahead and get some coal from over here, if I have any. Great. Aren't I smart? Alright, let's just go get ourselves some coal. Sorry guys, I've really done a bad job with this video so far. I'm really trying, okay? So, yeah, put some coal in here, and yeah. You can see the steam container go up. It's actually amusing to watch the numbers go up to me. Now, with this, you can go ahead and put the steam in there, or if I remember correctly, you could actually go ahead, because if you don't have a steam container in here, the steam just goes out, I believe. So I'll try to put particles on. Yeah, see? The steam will just go out, and I think you can actually just run it off the steam there if you put that on top of it. I'm not 100% sure. I think that's how it works, but I might just be going crazy. Alright, so then there's a steam motor, which you can just go ahead and put that in, and it should run. Maybe only one that's full. Alright, now to make galvanized iron tube, it's that. To make a turbine is what is also used to create this. So you need two galvanized iron tubes and four galvanized iron ingots. So that's how you make the turbine. Now the steam motor is a steam container, iron rivets, iron plates, an iron cog wheel, and the turbine. That ends up creating this. So yeah, that's kind of it there. Alright, now what we need to do, we need to make a cylinder. So that's redstone, a piston, galvanized iron tube, and glass panes. Now, those are used for many other recipes, but this one is the first one that's used for, the sprinkler. So it's a bucket, iron cogwheel, galvanized iron tubes, and galvanized iron ingots. So what happens, you make the sprinkler. Now the sprinkler you can go ahead and put water into, and it will make, and it will water a 7x7 farm, it'll make a 7x7 farming area. And it'll keep it watered just like that. You don't even have to have any water in it. So I found that kind of cool. I thought that was a good idea. Now the clockwork crane. Well, that's something confusing. Alright, so this is what we're going to create right here, a servo table. Now this requires mechanical energy, as does this, this creates mechanical energy. I'm not sure how fast. God, why is it lagging so much? I'm taking particles back off. Let's see what else. Yeah, the servo table. Servo table creates the clockwork crane, the propeller, liquid drainer, and the fan. So, how to make it, starting off, you need brass rivets here. Now, brass rivets, it's just like iron rivets. Just get ingots and plates. Now, to make iron cables, you need three string and three iron plates, putting them, well, like that. And that only makes one, I think. No, it makes more, probably. Alright, so now what you want to do, you want to make a mechanical board. Now, this is kind of the basis of most of the things in here. So what you need are iron cables, brass cogwheels, and redstone to make a mechanical board. Just like that thing. Alright, So then what you want to do is create a servo arm. That requires two cylinders, four brass plates, two brass cogwheels, and a mechanical board. Yeah, it's starting to get kind of crazy and out of hand now, right? Yeah, you haven't seen much yet. Now here's the servo table, which you need four servo arms, one leather, one brass rivet, one mechanical board, and two obsidian. This requires mechanical power to run, and it lets you create liquid drainer, fan, and the clockwork crane. Now the clockwork crane is mechanical board and two brass ingots. Now this lets you run these much faster, much more efficient. Because as you can see, those don't really slow down, and they move a lot faster than when I use the wooden one. So like, look, we'll test. See? And yeah, this can't move too fast. Alright, so now what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and learn how to... What am I saying? Something about something. Alright, now here's the liquid drainer. The liquid drainer here, damn it, I'm screwing up my speech already. Alright, so what you need is a galvanized iron tube, cylinder, two glass bottles, two brass ingots, and a mechanical board. Now, this basically is a multi-storage kind of thing. So, you can go ahead. I'm just going to make a 9x9 grid. Is place down as much water as you want. It's kind of cool. In the sense that it can place virtually as much water as you want. So, I'm just going to go ahead and place it here. So look at that, and oh my, what have I done? Okay, so yeah, you can go ahead and fill it up with lava or water, but you can only fill it up with one of the kind. Oh god, I can't open chests holding it. That's good to note. Alright, now for the propeller. The propeller you can go ahead and make in a regular crafting table. What you require are four brass plates and four leather, and that's how you make a propeller. Now, for the fan. This you have to create on a servo table. What you require are four brass rivets, two brass plates, propeller, mechanical board, and iron bars. Now, I actually want to see this in action because, honestly, I haven't myself. And I think it's actually a really cool little concept. So let's go ahead. I wasn't sure if that was still spinning or not. Alright, inventory. Brass cog. Aha. Alright, so now to put down this thing. Now, I'm not sure if it... Oh, okay. I forgot. If you have it going clockwise, then it'll drag stuff in, like so. However, if you have it counterclockwise, I'm actually going to get rid of that so then it moves a lot faster. Oh, I should probably put that back. So if you have it going counterclockwise, then it'll move towards the fan. However, I need to put something here. That is the best genius ever. Alright, so if you put that there, and then you put a fan down, hook something up to it, it'll push you away, as well as any items that are in the way. This can actually work really well for creeper for a kind of a defense system or something like that. Anyways, that's it for this mod. Oh, that's right, zinc ore and copper ore. You can just find those underground. Kind of simple. Alright, now that's really it, actually. I'm thinking about putting this map link down in the description below. Just comment if you guys want it. I'll give it to you then. And like I said, I'll tell you guys how to make the galvanized ingots in the description below. And I really hope you guys like the mod. Go and check out the link, give the guy a little bit of a love, and yeah. I hope you really enjoyed the video. Sorry that it's kind of late and everything. It's kind of late coming out, and it's a long, boring video, but, you know, I'm not really good at making these exciting, and I haven't played this mod for a little while. I was meaning to review it, though. So anyways, it's a work in progress, so it still does have a couple bugs, but other than that, it's an amazing mod. I love it, and I hope you guys do too. Anyways, thanks for watching. This is XeriaX saying goodnight. Please like, comment, subscribe, tell all your friends about my videos. And I'll see you guys later in Hetaoni or Realm of Mad God or something. Anyways, see you guys later.
Bye!